आई एम दर्शना मोरे, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ फूड साइंस, के केवा कॉलेज ऑफ हॉर्टिकल्चर, नासिक. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अनदर टॉपिक, कल्टिवेशन ऑफ अरेका नट. बॉटनिकल नेम ऑफ अरेका नट इज अरेका कटेचू, अंडर द फैमिली ऑफ पाल्मी एंड अरेकासी. क्रोमोजोम नंबर ऑफ अरेका नट इज 232 एंड ओरिजिन मलेशिया एंड फिलीपींस. कॉमनली अरेका नट कॉमनली नोन एज बीटल नट. So then we will see the introduction of areca nut. It is a tropical palm mainly cultivated and used in Indian subcontinent for mastication. So the mainly use of areca nut is a masticatory purpose. Then arecolin is the main or the physiologically most active alkaloid present in areca nut up to the extent of 0.07 to 0.1%. Then it is also used for socio religious, then medicinal uses. Then areca nut leaf sheet is also used for preparing playing board. Then some of the research centers are working on areca nut. Central Plantation Crop Research Institute Regional Station Vittal, it is started from 1956. Then another research station is also working on areca nut, like Herihali, Pichi, Kerala, Mohitnagar, West Bengal, and Kahikuchi, Assam. So the some climatic requirement for areca nut cultivation. Firstly, the temperature. So the temperature requirement of areca nut is should be minimum up to the 4 degrees Celsius at Mohitnagar in West Bengal. And the maximum temperature range is up to 40 degrees Celsius at Vittal in Karnataka and Kanara in Kerala. Then, however, the temperature range between the 14 degrees Celsius to 36 degrees Celsius is suitable for the palm flourish well in this temperature. Then, rainfall. Areca nut requires abundant and well distributed rainfall. Then it grows in well tract of very high rainfall areas, and up to the rainfall up to 4500 mm and more. But also it can survive in low rainfall areas, 750 mm annual precipitation. During the summer season, prolonged dry, plants should be irrigated. Then soil requirement of areca nut. Areca nut cultivation is predominantly in gravelly lateritic soil of red clay type of southern Kerala and coastal Karnataka. So the most suitable soil for the areca nut cultivation is laterite, red loam and alluvial soil. Then it can be also grown in deep and well drained soil, preferably not less than 2 meter of depth for the development of root system. Then in plain region part of Karnataka, it is cultivated in fertile clay loam soils. And for the luxuriant growth of palm, deep black fertile soil or the clay loam soil are also suitable. Then we will see the some varieties of areca nut. In areca nut there are different varieties like Mangala, Sumangala, Srimangala, Sas, Calicut, etc. So the first is a Mangala variety. It is early bearing varieties and with more number of female flowers per inflorescence and higher nut set. It stabilizes quickly in comparison with local South Kannada varieties. It is released by CPCRI, Central Plantation Crop Research Institute, for the coastal areas of Karnataka and Kerala up to the altitude of about 800 meter above the mean sea level. So this variety mostly recommended for Karnataka and Kerala region. Then next is a Sumangala variety. It is tall type variety with partial drooping crown, and under the good management palm flower in 4 to 5 years after planting. Then the nut color is the deep yellow to orange and oblong to round in shape. The average yield of Sumangala variety is 17.25 kg of ripe nuts per palm per year, at the age of 10th year. This variety also released from CPCRI. Then next variety, Srimangala variety. This is also tall type variety and also partially drooping crown with longer internodes and sturdy stem. Then the flowering start after 4 to 5 years of planting. Then it is high yielding variety with the average yield is about 15.63 kg of ripe nuts per palm per year. Then the ripe nuts usually oblong to round in shape with deep yellow color and released by CPCRI. Then next variety is Mohit Nagar. This variety is also released by CPCRI and mostly recommended for the West Bengal and coastal areas of Karnataka and Kerala region. So the average yield of this variety is 15.8 kg of ripe nuts per palm per year. Then some of the hybrid varieties also developed in areca nut. So first is the Vittal areca hybrid 1. This is early bearing variety and dwarf with partially drooping crown, well spread leaves, sturdy stem, medium size oval shape and yellow to orange colored nuts. So this is the hybrid variety of areca nut, mainly dwarfing characters and oval shape and yellow orange color of nuts at the time of maturity. Then due to the dwarf variety, the cost of cultivation is also reduced, then spraying is also easy. Then average yield of chali per palm 2.54 kg, and it is released for coastal Karnataka and Kerala. So from the areca nut there are different process products are made prepared. First is a chali and second is a kotapak, and some of the central supari also prepared from the areca nut. So for the chali preparation, the average yield is 2.54 kg. Then Vittal areca hybrid 2. It is early bearer dwarf with partially drooping crown, well spread leaves, sturdy stem, medium size and oval shape and yellow to orange color. It is reduced for the cost of cultivation due to the dwarfing characters. Then yield of this variety is 2.64 kg of chali per palm, and it is released for the coastal Karnataka and Kerala region. Then some of the other varieties also developed, like Calicut 17, South Canara local, Kasargad local, then Kahi Kuch Tall, Swarna Mangala, SAS 1, Srivardhan, Sagar and Tirthali. Then after the varieties, we will see the selection and raising of areca nut planting material. For the cultivation of areca nut, more important factors of cultivation is the selection of mother palm or the selection of seed plantation. So the first is seed selection. The plantation should be free from diseases and having higher proportion of regular high yielding palms. Some of the criteria for the selection of mother palms. So the first is it should be early and bearing and high percentage of fruit sets. So of the several characters of mother palm studied as the age at first bearing and percentage of fruit set were found to be correlated with yield and are having high heritability. Hence it is suggested to select palm which are early bearing and have high percentage of fruit set. So it should be early bearing and high percentage of fruit set. Then age of the palm, it should select the middle age of the palm. So the collection of nuts from the selected palm can be commenced after the stabilization of yield, which is normally takes 4 to 5 years after the commencement of bearing. Then hence select middle age of palm 15 to 35 years with a robust crown. So the age of the palm between the 15 to 35 years. Then selection of seed nut. The weight of the seed nut, it should be more than 35 grams, which are fully ripe are selected. Then undersized and malformed nuts should be rejected. Then heavier nuts with the bunch not only give higher percent of germination but also produce a bigger seedling of better quality. So the above 25% of nuts within a bunch are light in weight. So the age weight of the seed nut, it should be more than 35 grams. Then selection of seedlings. 12 to 18 month old seedlings are transplanted in the main field and nut germinate in 53 to 94 days, that is 2 to 3 months after sowing. Then planting, spacing and alignment. So the planting time of areca nut is different according to the rainfall areas. So the first May to June in well drained soil and low rainfall areas. Then August to September in clay soils subject to waterlogging and heavy rainfall areas. So the planting time is different according to the rainfall. Spacing and alignment of areca nut. Areca nut can be planted different types of planting system like square, rectangular and quincus system. The alignment is a north-south direction and planting on quincus system or square system lowers the incidence of sun scorch. The planting distance is 2.7 by 2.7 meter is the ideal planting distance for the areca nut cultivation. So the grouping of tall and quick growing evergreen perennial shade trees on western and south borders, southern borders. Some of the shade trees are also grown in early age of the planting, like acacia species, jack, then kokum, neem, and coccinea and pungamia. These trees are creating shade on areca nut palm in the early age of the planting. Then tying of areca leaves on areca leaf sheath on the southwestern to expose a portion of the stem. For the protecting of stem from expose of sunlight, we can use as areca nut leaves or the areca nut leaf sheath. Then deep planting, shallow planting and nurse crop shading. So the first is a deep planting in the areas where the adequate drainage areas or the well drained soil, the planting pits is 70 to 90 centimeter deep. Then shallow planting pits 45 to 60 centimeter deep is done in areas where the heavy and abundance or the obstruction for the proper drainage. Then the nurse crop or shading during hot weather starting from October, the young seedlings may be protected against the direct exposure to by sun. So the artificial shading with the either coconut or areca nut leaves or the by raisins. Second one is the nurse crop, that is examples banana. So the for creating artificial shade, we can plant the banana or also coconut in areca nut field. Then to protecting the sun scorch, then season of sun scorch between October to January. Then manuring in areca nut. So the organic manure, FOM, compost, leaf green or cattle manure, 20 kg per palm per year. Then fertilizer is recommended dose of fertilizer is 140 gram of NPK per palm per year is applied in two equal split doses. First is the pre-monsoon, that is in May-June, and second dose of fertilizer is in a post-monsoon, September-October. So the apply 1/3 dose of recommended dose of fertilizer after the 1 year of planting and 2/3 at the age of second year, and full dose of recommended dose of fertilizer from third year and onwards. Then the method of fertilizer application. The first dose is May-June in a broadcasting of that means the method of fertilizer application for the first dose is a broadcasting method. Without and broadcasting around the base of and mix with the soil by light soil working or the forking. And second dose of fertilizer application by the method of basin application September-October. Dig out the basin at the depth of 15 to 20 centimeter and radius is about 75 to 100 centimeter, leaving 20 centimeter from the base of the pump. Then irrigation for the areca nut is water requirement for areca nut December to February 12 liter of water per pump per day and March to May 20 liters per pump per day. So the irrigation intervals is differ according to the season. So in a west coast major areca nut growing areas interval of irrigation recommended are at the rate 175 liters per pump per irrigation November December 7 days of interval January February 6 days and March to May 3 to 5 days of interval. In system of irrigation in areca nut in a traditional or earlier method is bunding or storing water in a drainage and irrigation channel. Water is allowed to percolate. And second method is modern method, that is a sprinkler irrigation and also micro irrigation like drip irrigation and micro sprinkler irrigation. This method is mostly used for the areca nut cultivation. Then for the high density of areca based on multi crop plantation. Then another is the mulching is also done in areca nut. So the for mulching, in general mulching refers to use of straw leaves spread over the ground. Materials mostly used for the mulching is crop residues, husk, peels, straw leaves, then paper, plastic films and dry soils. So the season of mulching is during the summer month. Mulching is necessary for the areca nut cultivation. Then multiple cropping in areca nut is also done. For the multiple cropping, when it is referring to plantation of crops, it denotes growing more than one annual and perennial crops in the interspace for the main crop. For the multiple cropping, cocoa is the main crop in areca nut cultivation. So the in areca nut cocoa is cultivated 2.7 by 2.7 meter in alternate rows of areca nut and cocoa trees. And then next is the intercropping. As applied to plantation refers to growing of annuals or the biennials in the interspace of main crops like turmeric, ginger, elephant foot yam, tapioca, Dioscorea, sweet potato, etc. are grown in areca based intercropping system. And next one is the mixed cropping is also done in areca nut cultivation. It refers to cultivation growing of perennials along with the main crops. Areca nut base mix with the cropping system banana, cocoa, pepper and betel vine. Then multi-storied cropping system is also done in areca nut. Refers to a compatible combination of crops having varying morphological frame and rooting habits crowned together in such way that their canopies intercept solar energy at varying height and the root forage the soil mass at a different zone depth. Example, areca nut base multi-storied cropping system. Then nurse cropping are the annuals or perennials growing during the early years of plantation crop with the view product them against the scorching winds and also the frost damages the banana crops grown in the initial age of areca nut plantation. So the nurse crop like banana is also grown in areca nut cultivation. Then harvesting of areca nut. The harvesting of areca nut it should be done by the manually and in other countries by the mechanical method is also done. So the most common practice of climbers is to climb a palms at the end of the garden. Harvest the bunch and pull the nearest palm with the help of hook and swing to it. Then one climber may harvest up to the 100 palms by swing from one palm to next at the stretch before coming down to the ground. So the one climber can harvest up to 100 palms. Then harvested bunch are dropped to the ground and lowered by using the rope or the gunny bags. Then ladder also used for harvesting of individual palms. In certain parts like long bamboo with a sharp sickle hook are attached to the end of end are also used for harvesting. Then harvesting of areca nut is depends on the which type of a product should be prepared. So the areca nut, the stage of maturity of nuts at harvest varies depending on the type of produce that is to be prepared. So the season of harvesting for the chali preparation, that is kalipak preparation, November to March, from blooming to maturity takes about 9 to 11 months, and fully ripe bunch are harvested for preparing kotapa or chali. So the for a process product preparation of kotapak or the chali, fully ripe nuts should be harvested. That takes about 9 to 11 months, and about 6 to 7 month old nuts, which are dark green and soft, are harvested to produce kalipak. So for the preparing kalipak, dark green and soft nuts at about 6 to 7 month old should be harvested. There are two categories of areca nut based on the method of involved in a processing. Kotapak mainly consumed in North India, and in Gutka industries, Kalipak consumed mainly in South India. So the major diseases and pest in areca nuts are mites, red ant fly, then spindlebug, root grub, tender nut drop, and thrips. And second diseases of areca nut is Coleogora mahali or fruit rot, then bird rot, inflorescence dieback or the button shedding, anabiroga or fruit rot, then wild leaf, then leaf blight. Thank you.